This is the Montgomery County Infants and Toddlers Program. We provide specialized instruction to students who qualify from the earliest ages, even before they would enter preschool. So if a parent suspects a developmental delay in their child, they would contact the Department of Health and Human Services in Montgomery County for the referral.
Can you please tell me what the concerns are for your child at this time?
We are the single point of entry for infants and toddlers who have developmental disabilities. And the number is 240-777-3997. And then our intake workers will speak with the family and direct them where they need to go.
Once that referral is made, we provide screenings in the communication area, speech and language, motor development, cognitive development, or any other delay that might be suspected. This is considered specialized instruction, special education services. Maryland is a birth mandate state, so students who are eligible can get services right after birth up until they turn 21. So the Infants and Toddlers program is the first program a family may access for students who are eligible and require these services.
There is no cost for this program. It's supported by federal and state dollars and local dollars. And it's early intervention, and it's considered essential to make sure that kids are entering kindergarten ready to learn. Montgomery County Public Schools is our number one partner to support this program, to make sure that we have top quality therapists and special educators working with our children.
We have physical therapists, occupational therapists, speech pathologists, teachers, psychologists, vision specialists, hearing specialists. Everything is individualized. Depending on the child's needs, a psychologist may come in to do an observation, may come in to help the parent, may come in to do some more in-depth testing. If a child has physical needs, a physical therapist would be helping the parents and helping the child. And oftentimes there are several providers with one child.
The focus is not only on the child, it's also on the needs of the family. When a family finds out their child has a developmental delay, it can be very devastating. And our staff is experienced in helping families not only accept that news, but understand the developmental delay and provide them with the supports that they need. It helps everyone to bring out the best in the child. We have 5 geographic locations throughout the county, one in the Down County area, one in Mid County at the Children's Resource Center, one at North County at Emory Grove Center, we have East County, and we have Up County. And also our providers are providing services to children in their home, which is considered a natural environment. We might provide some services in a community setting, in a daycare, or even in a grocery store if that's needed.
The goal of the Infants and Toddlers program is a parent coaching model. So when we go into the home, our job is to teach the parents how to help their child because the parents are with them all the time. They're their main teacher.
Where what he might be interested in, that you will bring it and put it with you. So he's playing it more with you.
If a family requires translation services, let's say into another language that's other than English, we provide translators to come into the home.
You know, we talked about keep it fun, keep it going. How did you keep it going?
We provide evening parent trainings where parents come in and they learn how to best speak with their children, how to help them develop their vocabulary and their communication skills.
We really try to build in things that the parents can do in their everyday routines, and it's not supposed to feel like work, it's supposed to be things that they would do with their child. We just kind of tweak what they would do in their interactions every day to help build those interaction and play and communication skills.
As opposed to reading directly in front of him, face to face, I was reading behind him, or he was, you know, beside me, and they said, no, just tweak it a little bit, put him directly in front of you so that he can see your lips, he can see how you're pronouncing words and things like that, and it worked very well.
We will go into the home 3 times during this program and watch the parents and video the parents with their children. And then we review the videotapes with the parents. And the idea is for the parents to become aware of their own interaction style with their children.
They may shut the video off and then model with each other on how they would work with their child.
Look at Brandon, where's the fish?
This uses the 4S strategy. Say less and stress, go slow and show to make reading more interactive and dynamic.
Red balloon.
Balloon.
And you could have a red balloon.
Yeah.
Like, and then yeah. Play with the red balloon.
Families get to meet other families that are dealing with many similar issues with their own children. We provide services in what we call the natural environment, and we use community centers in order to work on some of the skills. Parents can drop in with their children, and a team of providers helps the family have the child interact in first some free play activities, and then they may do a small structured activity like a circle time. This helps prepare children for preschool.
We're here to kind of practice some of those school readiness skills, you know, being part of a group and advancing their language skills just a little bit. Through what they're interested in doing and following their lead, you know, we're able to kind of hit on some of those early learning concepts.
Our kids come in and they're side by side with typically developing kids, which is something that we really support and want to see happen. And they're all learning at the same time, and learning is fun, and they're learning basic language and literacy concepts, but nobody can really tell because it's so much fun to be reading books and doing activities. The parent resource centers are really key, I think.
There's been a recent change with the Maryland State Department of Education that allows families to make a choice at age 3. And if their child remains eligible for special education services, they may choose to stay with the Infants and Toddlers program rather than going on to special education in preschool. No matter which path a family chooses, the services are tailored around the needs of the child. And both paths have the goal of preparing children for school readiness at kindergarten.
We're really trying to identify those children with autism spectrum disorder because there is actually research to support that the sooner you get in there, the better it is for most of those children, because some of them can be quite high functioning and it really can make a difference in terms of how they enter school ready to learn. And that's the purpose of our program. If a parent has a concern about their young child's development, they can certainly check in with their pediatrician first and ask some good questions, but they're certainly free to call the Infants and Toddlers main number and we will talk to them and we will help them make a good decision in terms of what the next steps might be.
Once your doctor refers to Infants and Toddlers, the intake line, they're talking to you in 24 to 48 hours. And they're setting something up within a week to assess your child.
With very young children, you have a developing brain and a developing body and a developing personality. So the earlier that you can reach a child and reach a family, the more impact you can make on the trajectory of that child's development.
I think it's hugely important to make sure that all children get what they need to be able to function at their best so that they can contribute to our community and our neighborhood life and be fully involved. That makes a very big difference in terms of family satisfaction, healthy community life, and a successful society.